Hello, my friends. My name is Z from Lorestar, and Dash asked me to come on and do a guest video today to talk about the Mass Effect reveal trailer. He really did want to cover it for you guys, but with Cyberpunk taking up so much of his time, he asked if I would come in to cover the trailer and see if you guys are interested in Dash covering Mass Effect going forward. Unsurprisingly, there are numerous Easter eggs and references to other parts of the Mass Effect universe peppered throughout the reveal trailer for Mass Effect's Return. And I'm here today to talk to you about the most interesting ones, with 10 tiny details you may have missed in the Mass Effect Return reveal trailer. The first item on our list comes to us from the final shots of the trailer, and it is a shot of none other than Liara Tassoni. Of course, this confirms that this new series will be taking place in the Milky Way galaxy and not the Andromeda galaxy. In my first viewing of the trailer, I was just so excited to see Liara that I actually missed the wrinkles on Liara's face. Asari can live to be well over 1,000 years old and enter 3 various life stages, and it would appear that Liara is very clearly in her matriarch years. We are seeing here matriarch Liara, which would tell us that this shot comes some at least 700 years after the events of Mass Effect 3, which was a really good decision because it allows them the time they would need to return the galaxy to a sort of status quo that they wouldn't have to account for all of the various decisions made in Mass Effect 3. However, I can't help but feel some remorse at seeing this as well, that everyone we love besides Liara and maybe the Krogans would certainly be dead, with Tali and Garrus and everyone else certainly gone by this point. It is a sad thing to think about, but it is, I think, a really good decision to set this new game so many centuries in the future.
I will inflict upon
Mass Effect Andromeda
the greatest insult an enemy can suffer: to be ignored.
Throughout the entire trailer, they want to make it clear that this takes place in the Milky Way galaxy and not the Andromeda galaxy. And the trailer actually opens with a really cheeky shot to demonstrate that first and foremost, where we see both the Milky Way galaxy and the Andromeda galaxy from a zoomed out view. And of course, as the camera zooms in, it makes it very clear that it turns away from the Andromeda galaxy and goes into the Milky Way galaxy, which I thought was a very, very clever and sly way of telling us that they know that what we really want is more stories about the Shepherd. The entire trailer has a theme of following humanity and their history of space travel, going all the way back to the 20th century through the events of Mass Effect 3. Around the 22nd mark, they reference Arcturus Station, which was humanity's first outpost beyond the Sol system. Being only one relay jump away from Sol, it was humanity's first outpost, and it became the base of the Systems Alliance Parliament and Navy. Arcturus was destroyed in the Reaper War, but this is a reference to the First Contact War. The next line comes to us: unknown vessels approaching, we need first contact protocols. And this is a reference to the Human-Turian War known as the First Contact War. The Turians were the first aliens to make contact with humanity, as the Turians, which were basically dinosaur space Romans,
hell, Garrus, you were always ugly. Slap some face paint on there and no one will even notice.
Were enforcers of galactic law in Citadel space, they declared war on humanity for activating dormant mass relays, since humans were unknowingly breaking Citadel law. The war was bloody, but relatively short, and an olive branch was extended to humanity, welcoming them into the greater galactic society known as Citadel space. Around the 42nd mark of the trailer, we can see in the background a mass relay totally destroyed as we progress into the darkest war of this cycle, the Reaper invasion. The mass relays were destroyed in the war, along with the Reapers, effectively stunting interstellar travel. And we can see here that there is a mass relay still destroyed, the debris floating around in space. Paired with the Reaper cry that we can hear in the audio, this shot is taking us through the timeline of Mass Effect 3. The trailer really begins to climax at the 1 minute mark, where we see an unknown shuttle landing on an icy planet. A detail that I found rather odd was that this planet is very distinctly not Earth, despite the fact that that was the location of Commander Shepard's death. We can tell this isn't Earth because the fact that the planet has two moons, and despite the fact that it is rather icy and cold, it wouldn't be unreasonable to assume that it could have been a cold part of Earth, but unless Earth has gained another moon in the next 700 years, this must be a, as of yet, unknown planet. Although it does bear some similarities to the planet seen in the epilogue of Mass Effect 3. While we are walking through this icy planet, we can see in the background the skeletal remains of a dead Reaper, again confirming that this is firstly the Milky Way galaxy and secondly in the post Mass Effect 3 timeline. Around 1:22, when we first see Liara, if we look behind her, we can see three figures near her shuttle. The figures are a Salarian, a Krogan, and what looks to me like a Drell. The middle species is really undefined, but they are humanoid, and especially looking at the legs and how they bend forward at the knees like a human's legs would, but the head does not look human to me, leading me to believe that this is actually the species known as the Drell, most famously the species of our favorite Drell assassin, Thane Krios. Behind the group, we can see a shuttle which has the letters XT8 on the side. We've seen this shuttle in various concept art pieces that have already been released for the game, which seems to suggest that it will play a large role in the game's travel, perhaps filling the same role as the Kodiak shuttle in Mass Effect 2 and 3, or even the dreaded Mako in Mass Effect 1. The last detail I want to talk about is one that I'm not totally sure about, but above Liara, we can see a silhouette shape in the clouds that seems to me very reminiscent of the signature silhouette of the Normandy SR2. While the wings are certainly elongated compared to the length of the body, as we see normally in the SR2, the wings usually come up to the halfway point of the body of the Normandy, whereas these wings seem to go all the way to the front of the body. If this is the Normandy SR3 or a completely new ship, or just a group of clouds that are made to give us a nice little nod and Easter egg, I can't know for sure, but it is still a really cool shape to see in Mass Effect going forward. But anyway, those were 10 tiny details that we noticed in the Mass Effect reveal trailer. Were there any we missed? Let us know down in the comments below. And thank you again for joining me here today, and thank you to Dash for letting me be a guest on the channel and sharing in Mass Effect, which is my favorite non-Star Wars space story. And thank you guys so much for watching. Let us know in the comments if you want Dash to continue covering Mass Effect. I've been trying to convince him that he needs to do that for a long time now, so let him know. Alright guys, thank you so much for watching, and as always, may the lore be with you, now and forever.